Whether it was counting down the seconds to an artillery barrage, or counting down the seconds to order men over the top, as they say, the wristwatch played an important role in the life of soldiers in the trenches during the First World War. For four straight years, men would live and die by the clock. But it was actually during the Second Boer War where British soldiers would strap pocket watches to their wrists. But these pieces tended to be clunky and cumbersome. Timing on the battlefield was more crucial than ever. For the men serving on the front, the wristwatch was an essential part of their equipment. The pocket watch had been replaced by what was more convenient and quicker to glance at a moment's notice. The modern wristwatch design we take for granted today was born of war, and its life began a professional timing instrument. The wristwatches men wore during the First World War were often pieces that were purchased by themselves or were given to them as gifts. Often jewelers would cater to servicemen and offer a service-style wristwatch. The term trench watch was slapped on by jewelers looking to make a sale on the growing number of servicemen looking for a wristwatch. As the war went on, wristwatches took on many different appearances. The majority of them would be in the familiar design we know as a trench watch, a round case with thin wire lugs. The case back would open up like a pocket watch, displaying the movement. Some would have a protective case on the top protecting the watch. These things were known as shrapnel guards. It's unknown where the concept first came from, but it was quite popular during the war. Also, there was an oversized crown, which made setting the time easy while wearing gloves. By 1915, many watches were upgraded with radium dials, so that the soldier could tell the time in the darkest of nights. Some simply had radium dots applied in the place of Roman numerals. This was the birth of the black enamel dials with luminous markers that would be the standard for military watches during the Second World War. After the war, wristwatches became mainstream and were a necessity for the working man, and a fashion statement for the ladies in the 1920s. The war changed the world of horology, and forced advances in the world of watchmaking for the next few decades. Although this generation does not garner the wristwatch as in high regard as the generation of men that were lost during the 4 years of the First World War, these wristwatches should be just as important now as they were then. I applaud collectors that seek them out and restore them to working condition. They aren't just a great part of horological history, but living pieces of our own history. One we at times struggle to remember, but one we should never forget.